In the last lecture of the analog communication, we saw the derivation of the upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal by using Hilbert transform. In this lecture of the analog communication, we will see the derivation for the lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal by using Hilbert transform. So let's get started. Again, let's say our modulating signal or message signal MT is band limited to the frequency W Hz. And the carrier frequency FC is greater than W Hz. In the frequency domain, the lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal can be given by. Again, we have said that this lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal can be represented by spectral components of M plus of T and spectral components of M minus of T, which are capital M plus of F and capital M minus of F. So to represent the negative part of the lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal by using the spectrum of M plus of T, which is capital M plus of F, we need to shift capital M plus of F by the frequency minus FC. And to represent the positive part of the lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal by using the spectrum of M minus of T, which is capital M minus of F, we need to shift capital M minus of F by the frequency FC. So the lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal in the frequency domain can be written as M minus of F minus FC plus M plus of F minus minus FC, which can be written as M minus of F minus FC plus M plus of F plus FC. Now let's take a signal XT in the time domain, and according to the properties of the Fourier transform, if we take the Fourier transform of the signal XT, it will have the Fourier transform capital X of F in the frequency domain. Now, if we multiply e to the power j 2 pi f naught t with the signal xt in the time domain, then according to the property of the Fourier transform of the signal xt, which was capital X of f, will be shifted by f naught in the frequency domain. So the Fourier transform of e to the power j 2 pi f naught into xt will be capital X of f minus f naught. Similarly, if we multiply the signal xt by e to the power minus j 2 pi f naught t, then in the frequency domain, the Fourier transform of the signal xt, which was capital X of f, will be shifted by minus f naught, or Fourier transform of the signal e to the power minus j 2 pi f naught t into xt will become capital X of f minus f naught, which can be written as capital X of f plus f naught. So according to the properties of the Fourier transform, we can write capital X of f minus f naught has the inverse Fourier transform of e to the power j 2 pi f naught t into xt, and similarly capital X of f plus f naught has the inverse Fourier transform of e to the power minus j 2 pi f naught t into xt. Now lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal in the frequency domain can be given by capital M minus of f minus fc plus capital M plus of f plus fc. And if we apply the formula of the inverse Fourier transform, then we can write lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal in the time domain is equal to e to the power j 2 pi fct into m minus of t plus e to the power minus j 2 pi fct into m plus of t. Now m plus of t has the value of half into mt plus j into m cap of t, and m minus of t has the value of half into mt minus j into m cap of t. If we put this value in the equation, then it can be written as lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal in the time domain is equal to e to the power j 2 pi fct. For m minus of t, we can write half into mt minus j into m cap of t plus e to the power minus j into 2 pi fct, and for m plus of t, we can write half into mt plus j into m cap of t. By taking mt and j into m cap of t common from the equation, we can write lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal in the time domain is equal to mt into half into e to the power j 2 pi fct minus half into e to the power minus j 2 pi fct plus j into m cap of t into minus half into e to the power j 2 pi fct plus half into e to the power minus j 2 pi fct. If we take half out of the square bracket and take minus common from the term, j into m cap of t into minus half into e to the power j 2 pi fct plus half into e to the power minus j 2 pi fct, then SSB-SC modulated signal in the time domain can be written as half into mt e to the power j 2 pi fct minus e to the power minus j 2 pi fct minus half into j m cap of t into e to the power j 2 pi fct minus e to the power minus j 2 pi fct. Here, e to the power j 2 pi fct has the value of cos 2 pi fct plus j sin 2 pi fct, and e to the power minus j 2 pi fct has the value of cos 2 pi fct minus j sin 2 pi fct. If we put this value in the equation of lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal in the time domain, then it can be written as here j sin 2 pi fct and minus j sin 2 pi fct will cancel out each other, and also cos 2 pi fct and minus cos 2 pi fct will also cancel out each other. After this can be written as lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal in the time domain is equal to half into mt into 2 cos 2 pi fct minus half into j m cap of t into 2 j sin 2 pi fct. This half and 2 inside the square bracket will cancel out each other. Then we can write lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal in the time domain is equal to mt into cos 2 pi fct minus j square m cap of t into sin 2 pi fct. This j square has the value of minus 1. So if we put this value in the equation, then we can write lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal in the time domain is equal to mt into cos 2 pi fct plus m cap of t into sin 2 pi fct. So SSB-SC signal with only USB transformer has the equation mt into cos 2 pi fct minus m cap of t into sin 2 pi fct. And SSB-SC signal with only LSB transmitters has the equation mt into cos 2 pi fct plus m cap of t into sin 2 pi fct. That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.